Hello, John here again, and welcome to episode 5 of Tutorial 37, which is the Hunchback Community Game Development Series. Right, in the previous episode, we set up a Raspberry Pi to be able to code in the Python Pi game system, and also as a treat to be able to show you how you can create a Commodore 64 development environment on the Raspberry Pi using the Kick Assembler system. Well, for those guys that haven't got a Raspberry Pi that want to help and follow, this is the way you can do it on your computer. And what we're going to do is we're going to take the Raspberry Pi desktop image and run it in a virtual machine and set it up in exactly the same manner as the Raspberry Pi, so you guys can follow along as well and contribute to the course. So, without further ado, shall we get started? Now, the first thing you need is the image. And the way to get the image is you go to raspberrypi.org, click downloads, and then it's this Raspberry Pi desktop image. So you need to download that and store it on your hard drive. Now, be warned, it's a good 2 gig, so it will take some time, but I've already downloaded it and I've got it ready. The next thing you're going to need is some virtual software. Now, I'm using VirtualBox from Oracle. It's free, you can download it for nothing, and it gives you the complete and utter control of a virtual machine on your computer. Now, it's version 6.1. Now, I'm not running 6.1, I haven't upgraded yet, so mine's gonna look slightly different, but not a lot different. So when you look at it, you'll be going, oh, I recognize that, even though it may not be exactly the same place. So you need to download VirtualBox, and you also need to download the extension pack. And the way to get to that is to go into downloads, scroll down a bit, and there it is, the extension pack. So you need to download that and then install it after you've installed VirtualBox. If you try and install it before, it has a fit. So install VirtualBox first and then install the extension pack afterwards. Once you've done that, you'll end up with something very similar to this, but not the same, because I think I'm running 5.2 still. Yeah, 5.2. But it's the same scenario, same system, just slight. I think it looks slightly different. All right. So the first thing that we're going to do is we're going to create a new virtual machine. So Hunchback VM. It's not going to be Windows. It's going to be Linux, and it's going to be Debian. And it's 32-bit, because the Raspberry Pi, even though it's a 64-bit machine, the operating system is still only 32-bit. So you have to make sure you highlight 32-bit, or if you try and install the image, it has a bit of a fit. All right, so we'll click next. So I'm going to give it 4 gig of RAM, just like the Raspberry Pi. You guys, you can give it whatever you want. So if you've only got an 8 gig machine, then give it 2 gig of RAM. It still will work. You know, this image works in 1 gig of RAM, right? So you don't have to give it the sort of memory I'm giving it. But I, as you can see, my computer has 64 gig of RAM on board, so I can spare it. Click next. Then we're going to create a virtual hard disk. So create. We're going to use a VirtualBox image, do next. We're going to make it dynamically allocated. And what that means is the image will grow as you store more and more stuff on it. So instead of making an image the size of what you've told it to be, it starts small and works its way up. So you're not gobbling up hard drive space for no reason at all. Click next. Right, I'm going to tell it it's 32 gig because that's the SD card that I put in the Raspberry Pi. And then I'm going to tell it to create. There you go. Now we're going to do a couple of things to this. So what we need to do is go into settings, and we're going to create a shared folder. And basically this allows you to talk to your host, so you can swap files between your host and the virtual machine. Now I've created a folder in my temp directory. Tell it to select, want it to auto mount, not read only, because we want to be able to talk to it. Click OK. And then click OK again. I'm just thinking if there's anything else I need to do before I do that. No. Oh, yes, here. Nearly forgot. You need to go into storage, and you also need to mount the ISO file you've just downloaded from the Raspberry Pi organization. So there it is. So this one is February this year. So it's relatively new, but there's still a couple of updates that will be applied to it. So we're going to click that. I'm going to click OK. So that's now effectively, we have got a machine that's powered down. We put the disk in the seat, we put the DVD in the drive, and now we're about to power up, and it will boot off that DVD. So here we go. Start. Right, let's move this. So up there. Right, so it's telling us what do we want to do, and we want to do an install. So, yes, of course I'm British. Here we go. So that's just told it what keyboard layout and the region we're in. Ah, nice slurp of a cup of tea. Now it's going to ask us what we want to do with the disk drive. Here we go. So I want to use the entire disk, and that's the disk I'm using. And yes, all files on one partition. And finish. So off it goes. Do you want to make the changes to the disk? Why not? Now, this is going to take some time. So what I'll do is I will fast forward through it until we get to the next step. See you in a minute. Right, so now it's asking us to, it seems that this is a new installation, is the only operating system on this computer? If so, it would be safe to install the grub loader to the master record. So basically, yeah, we need to install this on the master record. So we click yes. Click yes, and then we tell it which drive to install, which partition to load up. So we're going to tell it's that one. Right, we'll let it run again because this might take a little while, and I'll talk to you in a minute. Right, so that's it, it's installed. So, and if you've noticed, it's auto ejected the CD. That's why it says take the CD out of the drive, because it's already ejected it. And so if it was a proper machine, the CD would be popped out. So let's say, tell it to restart. So here we go. So here we go, we're rebooting. So now it's asking us, what do we want to do? We want to do that. And hopefully it should take us in. Wait for it, wait for it. There we go. Right, so now it's we're being set up, so we're going to do next. Yes, we're in Britain. Okay, we'll do that. Yes, we'll get it to do an update. Now, because this is only, what, 2 months old, it shouldn't take that long. But it depends if you guys, you know, there may be some more updates there. So I'd give it a good 10 minutes if you're not doing this at the same time as me, which you wouldn't be because I'm doing it recording and I ain't released it. Ignore me. Right, now the system's updated, so we've click OK and it's going to want us to restart. So here we go, full on reboot. Yes please. And there we go, so that's a clean install of Raspbian, well, Debian desktop. Now, the beauty of VirtualBox is that you can take snapshots. So if you completely screw something up, you can go back. So what we're going to do is we're going to shut it down. There we go, shut down. Click on snapshots. I'm going to take one. And we're going to call it that this is the clean install. Okay. And then we're going to start it back up. So now we can go back to the clean install if we need to, if we've screwed it up. And that's one of the good things about a virtual machine. It's not permanent if you do it wrong. And you don't have to start from scratch if you've got your snapshots set up properly. So now what we need to do is we need to install the extension pack. Now, unfortunately, Debian doesn't have the extension pack in its repository, so we've got to manually do it. So we need to start up a terminal. Now, we've only just done this, but I'm going to do it anyway, because it could be that you guys haven't done the update. So you need to do the update first. There we go, so that's done. And then we need to install a couple of things. So sudo apt install and build essential and module assistant and DKMS. Right, hopefully I've got all that right. Here we go, and away we go. Done. See, that's how quick it is. And then the last one is m-a prepare. Sorted. Now, what we need to do now is, if you click on devices, you can now put the extension packs guest edition CD into the drive. So we're going to do that. Now, Linux is going to, there we go, so Debian opens it up, so that's all the stuff, but the problem is we can't run it, we've got to do something else. So this is what we need to do. So it's sudo sh slash media slash cd-rom slash vbox linux editions dot run, and this should install the extension pack to this image. Now this takes about 5 minutes, I think, so I'll speed through it and I'll see you on the other side. Right, so it's done that. So we're going to eject the CD. There you are, it's gone. And now we're going to tell it to reboot. Right, the dead giveaway, if it's working, is we've got this share here because this is our shared folder to the host. And also, we should be able to do this. There we go. So it's resized. So we'll get rid of the VirtualBox banner at the bottom and do that. That's it. And we will get the clipboard to be shared. That's by doing devices. And shared folders is, yeah, drag and drop. Yeah, we'll turn that on. Now, this is our area to the outside world from within here. So if we double hit it, we get this. And apparently, we have to set ourselves up. So this is what we need to do, yeah? So we need to add ourselves to a group. So it's sudo, according to this website, add user pi vboxsf. So that's adding me, pi, the user pi, to that group. Or they say. Right. So do we get access to here? Oh, we got to restart. Okay. Sudo reboot. So we'll log back in. All right, let's see if we've got access to it. And there's our, right, okay. Let's see if we can create a new file. Test.txt. Excellent, right, we should be able to see that. So, let's go in. Come on, show me the menu. I've got to say. Right, so, see, temp. Software test, and there's the text file. Excellent. So we've now got backwards and forwards communication between the host and the guest. Right, I think it's time to make another snapshot. So let's shut this down. So take another snapshot. Guest additions added. Right, start back up. Right. So, next thing we need to do is we need to make sure that Pygame's on here. Right, because that's the Python module extension or whatever you want to call classes, libraries that we're going to be using. So the best way to do that is to do sudo pip, which is Python installation process or something, install Pygame. There we go. So we've already got Pygame on here. So that's, we can now forget about that. So let's Now everything is exactly the same as what we did in the Raspberry Pi. So from now on, we're going to do exactly the same. So we're going to install Studio Code. So we're going to go on to that website, the Pi My Life website, and we're going to go to where we have to install the Visual Studio Code. So here we go, down here. So we know about all that. And so we need to do this in the terminal. Done. And then we need to do this. In the terminal. See how long this one takes. So 49 megabytes, and it's whizzing through it some chronic. There we go. It's now installed, so I can close this web browser down and we should see it. And there it is. Let's start it up. There you go, Visual Studio Code. We don't need that. And we don't need that. So there's a couple of extensions that we need to put on here now. So we're going to start with the PDF viewer, so VS Code PDF, which I think is that one. Yes, it is. So we'll install that. Okay, and then we'll install GitLens. We'll use the defaults. So that's done that. What else do we need? Oh yeah, Python. Use the Microsoft one. There we go. Sorted. And while we're here, we'll install the Kick Assembler one. So that should be it. So I think we need to do a reload by the looks on it. Yeah, reload required. Okay, let's do that. Sorted. Now, let's just check to see. Oh, it's there anyway, so I've got it open. Right, let's just see if Git's on here. Yes, it is. Right. So, the way we're going to do it is we're going to use some code that's already been written out there as a learning exercise, as well as us writing our Hunchback code. So, if you remember, I think it was back in January or something, or last year somewhere, I bought this book, you know, the Retro Gaming Raspberry Pi book, that shows you how to write retro games and in Pi game and some other things. Now if you notice, we got Pi Vaders, Hungry Pi Man and all that. So let's just click on there, and there's a URL here, look, Magpie CC, and that URL, so let's put this back in, that URL takes us to here. So that's the URL, so I'll make sure that goes in the link library. And what we're going to do is we're going to go into our machine and we're going to download it. So we'll fire that up go in there, grab it, and we're going to download. I mean, we could clone it. We could clone it. Should we clone it? Yeah, why not? Let's clone it. So we need to make an area on here. So file. Right, let's put it, do it in here. So documents, new folder, Python projects. And then in here, we're going to put a new folder called, what was it called? Pygame0. So we should be able to open that folder up. There we go. And we should be able to clone. Should be able to clone. How do we clone? I've forgotten how we clone. Do we initialize it and then clone? Let's try it. Let's initialize it. Right, can we clone from here? Doesn't look like it. Okay, let's do it from here. So, ls. Right, so git clone that. Oh. That's it. See if it does it. Right, according to that, it's done it. There we go. So this is all the... let's see what it looks like from here as well. Yeah, so it's got it all in there. So this is all the games in that repo. So if we do Evaders 2 and open up this, look, it's auto-detected. It's a Python file and it started highlighting. And the operating system, yeah, but that's fine. Don't show me again. And forget about these. It's because Visual Studio Code doesn't know about Pygame. And so it thinks there's something wrong. But we can still run it. So I think it's Control F5. Is it F5? Sorry. Shift Control P. Python. Yeah. So we should be able to do start without debugging, Control F5. Right, so Control F5. There we go. Space Invaders. Of course, a lot of bullets. All right. Now, we can use Visual Studio VS Code. But we could also use the editor that's been provided. So if we do this, programming, and then Thorny Python IDI, ADI, or whatever it's called, load. Come on. Or has it crashed? Oh, no. There it is. Documents, Python, Py0. And go into Vaders. Okay. Cancel. Now, this knows about Pygame. Yeah, because when they talk about it in this book, they're talking about the in-house editor. And so it knows about Pygame, so it knows about all the objects and everything. but it's already code that's already been written, so we can understand how they've done it. And as far as I can tell, they've not created any objects. It's all purely function based, which is the same as a Go sub in BASIC. So we should be able to understand it. Now, there's also another book that I got as well, which was this one, Code the Classics, Volume 1. Now, these books you can get from the Magpie website here. So if you go to Magpie, it's magpie.cc. So if we do magpie.cc, takes you straight there. And then you can click on books, and there's the Retro Gaming Raspberry Pi book. But the other one, Coding the Classics, is not done by these guys. So we have to go back to the Raspberry Pi system, and then I think it's in here. Oh, where was it? I think it was Wireframe. Now that's a tool. Here we go. Wireframe magazine. Here we go. And so let's put that in the list of links. And in here, if you go into books, you are Coding the Classics. All right, and you can still download it for free. So you don't have to pay for it, you could just download a PDF. I mean, that's the beauty of the Raspberry Pi Foundation. Now, I've got the physical books because I like to have a book, but I've also, as you see, got the PDFs. And the source code for that is here. So let me put that in the link file. And so we can download this as well. So let's do a clone of this. So let's do clone, grab it. Go back into the environment. So here, let's go back one, and again, and this time we'll create a new one called Code the Classics. Click OK. We'll open that with code, get it ready. So there's nothing there at the moment. So we'll come in here, we'll come back out of here. So Code the Classics and git clone that. Oh, it's not doing it. Hang on. Paste. That's Code the Classics. Oh. Done it again. Keep doing that. Here we go. So that's loaded it. And there we go. So we've got Boing. So let's open that up. So Control F5. No idea what that's doing. What version of Pi are we on? Alright, so we're on the right one. Width 800 by 480. Okay. Control F5, let's see if we do that again. There may be that you've got to fix it, and that's part of the thing. We'll have to have a look at it. I bet you've got in the book, I bet it shows you've got to fix it. Let's see if there's anything else. Soccer Manager. Alright, Control F5. Huh, okay. Let's close it down. Oh, there's windows open everywhere. Come on, close. Let's kill them off in Task Manager. Stop. Kill. Yes. 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 Oop. One more. Right, let's load it in that official Python one. Let's see if that has any difference. So we'll stop that. Quit. Oh, didn't want to quit. Want to close. So close that. Let's load up Boing. Right, run. Let's see if we get anything. There we go. Boing. One player, two player. So one player. Ooh, got it just in time. And we can use these as learning exercise. Oh, crack, that's getting quick. Ah! Use these as learning exercises. So if you download the same things, then you'll be able to see how they're made, and then we can use them when we're looking at doing Hunchback. So there's a few ideas. So I think it's time to shut it down and make a snapshot. So, added VS Code extensions. So now, because we've put kick on the kick extension on there, we're going to load up the Commodore 64 development environment. So we're going to build it from here. So it allows you to build it in here as well as on your computer. Here we go. So first things first, we need to get kick. But first we need to check, have we got the right Java on it? So if you do Java, oh, minus minus version. Yep. Version 11, so we can go and get kick. So let's grab kick while we're here. Here we go. Download. Done. Downloads. Extract here. Grab that little lot, cut it out. We'll create a new folder here called Assemblers. Kick, because we might install other assemblers on here. So we paste. So that's kick on there. So we've got VS Code, we've got kick. We now need Vice. So first things first, we need to set up our environment to be able to use Vice. Now the problem is Debian doesn't have Vice in its repo, so we're going to have to build it like we did with the Raspberry Pi. So we need to put that in, and that will be in the description. And this is going to take a while, so we'll say go. And yes. There we go, a couple of minutes later, and it's done all that. And now we need to download the source code of Vice. Now, I'm not going to download the latest version. I'm going to download a version I know that works. So we're going to download version 3.1. So I've just put this URL in. The link will be in the description. It's now downloading it, look. Wait for it to finish. Looks like that's done. So, going to downloads, extract it to here. Yeah, Vice 3.1. So let's have a look, see if, where are we here? Where in, right, so CD downloads, CD Vice. So now we're in the Vice system. So we need to run the compiler configurator, and that is this. As like I say before, it's in the description. So this is going to take a couple of minutes, so here we go. Right, that's done it. So now we're going to tell it to make it, to compile it. Now for the Raspberry Pi, it took 21 minutes. Started at 8, finished at 29. So here we are, 1404, go. There you go, it's 1409, so that was that. 5 minutes? Took 5 minutes to make, compile that, compared to the Raspberry Pi's 20. Yeah, it's a great little machine, the Raspberry Pi. Can't hit it with the big boys, especially on compiling anyway, so more than likely there was some throttling going on. Right, next thing we need to do on it is, now we've done the make, we now need to install. So we do sudo make install. So this is now going to install what it's just compiled. So here we go. Done. That's it. So we should be able to test it. X64. Now, yep, I know about that. So what we need to do, we just change the settings, and we go sound settings, change it to USS. And another thing, let's get this video done right. That's better. Settings. Save settings. Right, so that's that one. So let's try XVIC. Same issue again. So settings, sound, USS, settings, video. That one. And settings, save. Okay. Control Q is quit, I think. No? Control Q? Or is it Alt Q? Aha, Alt Q. Right, so C pet. No. X pet. Yeah, of course. Same issue. So, settings, sound, settings, video. Oh, there's no video. Here we go. That's better. So, settings, Alt Q, Now I'm going to do that again. So xpet. Can't tell if there was any sound there because I ain't got my headphones on. Well, that seems to be working. Control Q. X128. So same here. We'll do the sound there, and we'll do the video. Oh, so there's another video one in it. SDC. Filtered. There we go. Settings. Save. Alt Q. X plus 4. Settings, save. Alt Q. What else is there? I don't think it installed it here. No. So we've done the plus 4. Is there CBM? XCBM2. Yes. Do the same here. Settings, save. Alt Q. And I think there's a CBM5 in there. CBM5. No. See if I can find them. Oh, there they are. CBM2, XPET. Done the VIT. Oh, it's the XCBM5. Ah, crikey. No one would know that. It is okay. Settings, save. Right, quit. Right, let's set up the Vice system for here. So now we just need to set up VS Code. So we'll close this folder. And we'll go into the settings of the Kickass. So we can't get C64 debugger on here. I'm not sure. We can try. Let's have a look. C64 debugger. Files. Well, looks like you can. So we will go for, what am I running here? What am I running here? Right, 56.8. So we'll do the same thing. 56.8. That's this one. So is there a Linux one? Yes, there is. Right, okay, let's download this and see if we can get it to work. Right, so it's going to downloads. There it is. Okay, let's grab it, cut, paste it into here. I will paste it into there. Paste, there we go. And we'll see if it works. So that's the debugger. What's the README say? I think I've got everything in there. Well, let's double it. Let's see if it runs. Execute. Oh. Well, look at that. Well, I never. It's a bit sluggish. Permissions. All right, let's grab another one. Let's get a different version. Let's just see. Oh, C64 debugger. Now I've got. Let's try that one. There we go. So let's grab that one. Let's download that one. Let's go back into downloads. There we go. Extract. Cut. Paste that into there. See if this one runs. Execute. That's a bit quicker, isn't it? Right, we'll point it to that one for the moment. So, our 64 debugger is in documents. I'm going to do that one. 64 debugger. All right, Java. Kickass. Kickass is in here. And x64 work, but we'll leave that on. Right, so that's set. Right, file, new file, file, save as. So, documents, let's create another folder. My source, another one, hello world. And we'll call this hello world. Right, close that. Now we're going to open the folder now. Open the folder. There we go. So, need to initialize this. going to make it a Git repository. There we go. So now that's a Git repository. So hello world, and we'll go to my website and get the hello world post. So assembly issues and code, kick assembler code examples, hello world, select all, copy, close that down, paste it in. There we go. File, save. Alright then, so this should now run. So it should be the same command. So Control Shift P, let's just make sure kick. It should be Control F5. And it is. Control and run. Right, so Control F5. Where's the debugger? It didn't fire the debugger up. Oh, hang on. Extensions. Did you see the mistake? Missing the slash. Right, let's try that again. Control F5. Hey. Hello world. Right, let's change the settings so it, then to try and see if it does vice. So turn that off. Right, so that's saved. So if we do Control F5 now, it should fire up vice. There we go. Right, so yes, if I do Control Shift P, kick. Right, so build and debug is F5. So let's try F5. F5. Still goes into vice. Excellent. But it's got all the debug code. As you can see, look, it's set up all the debug code. So if we go into the source folder, yeah, there's all the debug code in there. And the beauty, because we've kicked off, Git, we can add all this to the source control. But the first thing we need to do is, if we go into there, can we add a ignore one? Want to be able to add it? Ignore. Doesn't look like it. Okay, so we'll go in here, let's see if we can do right click, ignore. No. Right, new file, .git ignore. And in here we should say slash bin star. So that should ignore everything in the bin directory. There we go. And .ig. No, we need that in there. File save. So now we should be able to add the two files to the. There we go. So let's add that, and let's add that to the staging area, and then first commit, and we commit it to the Git. Oh, okay. I need to set my name. So I'll do that. Still got this open. Right, so that is going to be that one, and then that one, sorted. Now we should be able to first commit, go, sorted, there we go. Now git len should have our history, there we go, got no branches. First commit, hello world. And there it is. Right. Hopefully, that's it. So here we go. So now we've got a Raspberry Pi set up to do Python coding and C64 coding. And for all those people that don't have a Raspberry Pi, we've got a virtual machine that does exactly the same thing, does the Python coding and the C64 coding. Now, as a caveat to that, you may not want a virtual machine. That's fine. You can still set up your machine to run Python and Pygame on your desktop. You just need to install the Python runtimes and you need to install the Pygame runtimes. Still use Visual Studio Code to edit it. You've already got the Kick VS Code environments. Some people have got Sublime. There's nothing wrong with that. It's a text editor, basically. VS Code is just a glorified text editor, like Sublime Text. Doesn't matter how which things you use, as long as we're using the Kick Assembler. We're using Pygame, Python 3.7, whatever it is, and that you can follow along and you can contribute. But please make sure you got Git set up so you can make sure that your code doesn't go belly if you do something wrong, because at least you can go back to the last commit. Right, if you like what I do, please hit that like button. If you didn't like what I've done, fine, hit the dislike button. Always leave me a comment. And if you like to support the channel in any way, and me in any way, then consider becoming a patron of mine. All the money raised in the channel is raised in Patreon is used for this channel. And with that, I'll see you in the next episode. Take care. Bye. I'd like to thank all the Patreons that are contributing to my channel. Without you guys, I wouldn't be able to do what I'm doing right now. Thank you very much.